Hey guys, welcome all. This video is going to be the continuation of our Atlanta trip. It's day 3. And we are going to visit the Atlanta Zoo. Though we had visited many zoos in the past, we decided to go to this one as my toddler son started recognizing animals, so thought it will be a fun for him. The first exhibit had the flamingos. I observed that all the zoos here have the flamingos as their first exhibit. Whatever it is, the pink color birds are always an eye catcher. Then there was meerkats. I like them for their unique standing position. Looks like they are looking out for something. And this one seems like quietly enjoying the warmth of the sunshine as it was very cold outside. And the elephants were not in the exhibit, they were kept inside because of the cold weather. The weather was really cold and the lion seemed to be relaxing in the sunshine. Then we moved on to the world of reptiles. Thankfully, it was an indoor exhibit so that for some time we could feel warm. And there was an alligator in there. I guess you could see the pythons in there. Different varieties of tortoise were kept. And sliced carrots were kept as their feed. It was always scary to find out where the snakes are inside the exhibit as they are always found folding themselves behind a branch or inside the corner or at the top, but this one was quite exposing. Found enjoying a nice shower. And there was a big aged turtle. And this was the setup for the exhibit with some unique birds in there. and that was a hornbill with a huge beak. And these were called as the crown pigeon. And they really look very elegant and beautiful. And there was this huge vulture, and with a unique vulture walk. And I'm seeing it for the first time. And there was a fake carcass of zebra to provide a natural wild setup. And the bald eagle, the national bird of USA. And these are from the rabbit family, and they were pretty big. And there was this panda exhibit. There were two big pandas in there. They look very cute with a beautiful spread of black and white colors on them. Many animals were not inhabited because of the extreme weather condition. It was really cold and windy there. We decided to come to the zoo for our son, but to the funnier side, he slept halfway through and we both were strolling around in the chilly condition. This zoo is the smallest comparing with the zoos we had visited earlier. And with this, we were done with the Atlanta Zoo and then we moved out. This building is the state capitol building of Atlanta. It was lunchtime and then we found a South Indian restaurant, Anjappa. We ordered mutton biryani and then parota with mutton salna.
The parota tasted good compared to the biryani.
That was chicken 65 biryani, I guess. That would be unfair to end a heavy meal without a sweet. I craved for ice cream, so bought a vanilla cone and a hot fudge sundae. We came to our room a little early that day. After relaxing for some time, I prepared tea and then we packed the excessive biryani that we had for lunch so that we could have it for dinner. So reheated it and had it for a dinner. And the next day after our breakfast, we checked out of the hotel room and then headed to our home. Before starting, had a coffee from the nearby Starbucks. Georgia state is nicknamed as Peach State because of the largest peach production. and this one symbolizes that, and I guess it was a peach farm. We stopped by IKEA, which was on the way to our home. I had few things to be bought from there and planned to have a lunch from there too. There was a small cafe inside the IKEA. We had a lunch from there. And that turned out to be a healthy lunch with veggie balls, beans, quinoa and some pastries and chicken and fries and then salmon balls. One of the reasons that I always like to go to IKEA is just to see the arrangements and the setups, and another one is the affordable pricing there. Then we drove back to our home. It got a little late, so we thought to buy our dinner from an Indian catering inside the halal meat shop that we usually shop by. They also have the best hot tea all the time. At last, home is where the heart is. As it was late, we had only less option available to choose from. We opted for chicken biryani. These are the few things that I bought from IKEA and the Coke store. A toy for my son. I like to buy souvenirs that symbolizes the place that I had been to. That's the salt or pepper shaker in the shape of a Coke bottle. A trinket box that symbolizes the Atlanta downtown buildings, a beach and the state capitol building. This ends the video on our Atlanta trip. So if you like the video, subscribe to my channel for more updates. Thanks for watching.